So because it sold off there, I mean, it didn't sell off real aggressive, but there weren't many, you know, there was hardly any machines in it to sell off. So, you know, the machines that did sell off got it under support probably, and it took out some stops. So now what you want to do is you want to wait for it to test this orange line. So you know, it didn't drop far under that orange line. So, you know, you want it to come down under the orange line, and then you want it to test the orange line and then come down again, and then that's where your short is. Now, you can do it however you want, right? Because I always miss 10 to 15% of a move. Because I wait for, you know, I try to wait for confirmations because it's less stressful. As you get old like me, you don't want the stress. You just want the easy money. So this will be interesting. Now, the problem is you got the close oil at the same time that it's underneath critical resistance now. And so you don't get the same trade this time of day. And it's not like until oil opens tonight. So between now and then, any of the trading that you see isn't really the true trade. So you just, you know, if you just started trading oil, you have to understand it's kind of no man's land between now and when oil opens tonight. So not that it's not being traded, it's trading. It's just that it's not the same. So you got to kind of be careful with your bias. So that's why between now and then I don't take an order. Now if I was trading futures, which is what we're going to be doing in, I'll be doing in the 24-hour trading room, is you know, at that point when oil opens, that's you know, as far as the charting is concerned, that's real trading. That's not no man's land. But because right now I don't trade futures, then I would wait until the morning to make my decision. Because between now and the time oil opens tonight, you can't even really look at the chart. You just can't. You know, where it's at right now is where in your mind's eye, your decision-making process should be, okay, that's where it is right now. It's just underneath that support, and let's see how it opens. But everything that happens between now and then, you really can't pay attention to it, because when oil opens tonight, they can take anything that happened during no man's time and completely erase it in 20 seconds when it opens. So it doesn't mean anything, period. It doesn't matter if it goes down or up, it doesn't mean anything. It means something, but nothing relative to, you know, its importance. So that's your basic lesson on what just happened. So that was an OPEC trick. They do that. They knew, you know, like that last down when it hit, not this resistance, but the last time when OPEC, when EPEC had called it weeks in advance, and everybody was on TV talking about how bullish it was, and we were saying there's, you know, there's a massive resistance. That there's a trending. There's a downtrending. If you go back into EPIC's reports, there's a downtrending resistance line where that cluster is. Here, I'll just help you out really quick. So there's another way to look at it, and that's with your conventional chart, because a conventional chart lines up with the algorithmic chart on the clusters. It's just done two different ways and looks two different ways on a chart, but I'll show you on a conventional chart where that cluster is. And that cluster is literally worse than any cluster in the last, well, it was more than a decade. Okay, so the conventional oil chart is right here. Well, conventional in the way that it's actually not like we had a number of conventional guys DM. Like, I had a number of conventional chartists talk to me about this chart, and they're like, well, that's not really conventional, but these lines were drawn off of conventional charting. Okay, I'm going to kill some stuff here. Here we go. Let's wait for it to come up here. So this is the conventional charting here. I just want to see what this person had to say. Wow, is that ever running slow? Brutal. Whoa. First of all, thank you for sharing this wonderful trade stuff. Looking forward to see the result. Okie dokie. Okay, now let's take a look at it. You know, it is nice when people thank you and like your stuff and whatever else. You're working away like a madman and you're like, nobody likes my shit. I'm so hurt. Recognition. Everybody likes recognition, I think. Okay. So that cluster, so on a traditional chart, it's all up in here, all scattered through there. But the thing is, it's all downtrending. That's the point I wanted to get across. So as you get further in time, in the time cycle, I think this red line right here, pretty much. Because it would be like this. It'd be like closer to this line here. That cluster, the bottom of the cluster. See how it's downtrending? So even if oil gets through here, once it gets up in here, man, like to get through there is like, well, it hasn't gotten through a cluster like that. And I can't remember how many years, 18 years or something. So it's crazy. So OPEC knows it's all there is the whole point. Anyway, there's one here. And, you know, it's not that thick. So the thicker the lines, the more important they are. But still, see how it failed? It failed right before that line. So the conventional chart lines up too. So that's your current range right here. And it might even, you know, expand as it goes, right? Some people would call that a horn, a bull horn of sorts. But that's bearish. Like even in conventional charting, that pattern is bearish. Darn it. Where did that bugger go? Oh, there it is. Yeah. But it gets through here, and you got to be cautious. Because your next test, well, where these three arrows are, right? Those are your tests. So your 200 day. That line and the support on the conventional chart. So you go back and forth from your conventional to your algorithmic model to OOTT. Make sure before you take a trade that you check OOTT and see if they're starting to mess up on you. That's the way she works. But that's you know, from an algorithmic modeling technician's perspective, especially one that's created the model. Or discovered the model. You can look at it both ways. Because we're just discovering what's already out there. But from my, from a nerd's perspective, that was pretty awesome today. What happened in oil? So I'm going to now take. Well, thanks, Beagle. I appreciate that. You can put that on social media. Scream it from the rooftops. I like their shit. After you spend time with Epic, you'll be screaming from the rooftops. I went through it. Everybody I know has basically gone through the process where they like, this is radical. Okay, I gotta find an afternoon setup and make some money here. Catch you in a few minutes.
Thank you.